Hello guys, so today we are going to discuss the problem from weekly contest 209. So this problem title is special array with x elements greater than or equal x. So what is given in the problem? Basically we are given an array which name is nums and it contains the non-negative integers, okay, and there can be a number x which can be existing or not, but what we have to find is we have to check. So let's say if we pick up a number x, so there has to be numbers which are greater than or equal to the x. So let's say if I have an array, so 2 is the number, so there can be like other two there can be some numbers, and out of that there can be the possibility like rest of the elements can be equal to 2 or it can be greater than 2, like 3 or 4 or 5, something like that, okay. And there can be the case like in the nums we would not be having the same element, okay, that x number. So in that case we can take the minimum number. So let's take an example. So this is the nums array and here there are two elements, 3 and 5. So if we can take a first element, that is the 3, and like if we think it in this way, like length of this nums is 2, so at any point, so there won't be any point where we can have the 3 is equal to 3 condition. So if it is the case, then we have to return the minus 1. But if you closely take a look at this line, notice that x does not have to be an element in nums. So here we can take the number 0 or 1 or 2. Okay. So if we take a number 0 and if we see like how many numbers are there which can be greater than or equal to 0. So like there are two numbers, but 0 is not equal to these elements. So same is the case with the 1. Now if I take a number as a 2, special number as a 2, so here my length of the array is 2, and again if I consider x is equal to 2, so there are other two elements in my nums array which are having the size greater than or which are having the value greater than 2, that is a 3 and 5, okay. So that is the whole idea over here. Now let's take a look at the code part now, okay. Just a minute. Yeah. So initially, I am taking n as a length of my nums array. Then what I am doing is, the number can be, that special number can be in the range of 0 to n. So this is my parent for loop. It iterates from 0 to n equal to n, and at every time what I will do, I will take this c as a count as a c, and I will iterate through this nums array, and if I find my j's value, that is a nums element value, is greater than my i's value, okay. So if it is the case, then every time I will increment my counter value by 1, okay. So for example, if you take this 3 comma 5 over here, when I is equal to 0, my c will be 2 because 3 and 5 both are greater than the 0. Now next thing, if I take when I is 1, so again c will be 1, okay. Now the last time when I becomes 2, at that time what will happen when I is equal to 2, because this length is 2, that is the size of the n is 2, so c will also become 2 over here. And finally what I will do, I will this perform this check if the I value is equal to the counter value. If it is the case, then that is the special number, that is a number as a x, okay. So I will return it. If it never satisfies, so for example if we take this 00, so for the 00 there won't be such case because length of the nums is 2, and if it iterates from 0 to 2, it will never satisfy this criteria, because it is like the counter value for this one never matches. Okay, so that is the whole idea of this problem. Let me run this program and show you the output. Yeah, so you can see the solution is accepted, and if you see the number of test cases, it has passed. So here it has passed all the 95 test cases. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching.